when you're not doing an accident, which we don't want accidents, we need to train. So by training, we're able to respond quicker. We understand what needs to be done. We have those tactics down. The command level works better.
New at 6, Southwest Florida is now home to just the second training ground for an elite group of firefighters.
It will bring crews from all over the Southeast and the Caribbean to Charlotte County. As NBC2's Samantha Serban found out, this taxpayer-funded project is expected to have a good return on investment.
This is only the second prop plane of its kind in the state of Florida. I want to point out these burn pits on the ground for you. Come summertime, these will be filled with 10 to 15 foot flames. Firefighters from all over will come here to train so they know how to rescue you should the worst happen.
It takes more than a hose and water to fight fires on a plane.
It requires training additional to what we need to do to be firefighters here.
Right now, the only place for aircraft rescue and firefighting, or ARF teams, to train is in Jacksonville, but not for long.
Charlotte County is installing an aircraft training simulator in order to do aircraft rescue training for our airport people.
It's got all the parts and pieces of a commercial airliner, including a cockpit and seats. This video is from the current ARF prop plane upstate.
We will be technically the second one in the state to provide a greater access and greater level of training to the airport firefighters throughout our state.
ARF firefighters are required for every airport in the country that has passengers. Here in Charlotte County, that's Station 7 and these two trucks that are on standby 24/7.
For us, we call it a specialty.
Remember that huge rental car fire at RSW in April of 2020? They were on scene. ARF requires regular training on a prop that goes up in flames and can be filled with smoke to run every imaginable scenario crews could face.
That's going to make the incident safer for the people traveling, safer for the firefighters that are there, safer for getting victims or putting out that fire.
Fortunately, working these aircraft emergencies in real time doesn't come around often. The fewer aviation accidents, the better for you and me. According to the National Safety Transportation Board, in the past 5 years, Florida investigators have responded to more than 500 aviation accidents. 95 of those involving a fatality.
When you're not doing an accident, which we don't want accidents, we need to train. So by training, we're able to respond quicker. We understand what needs to be done. We have those tactics down. The command level works better.
It's not just potential passengers, pilots, and firefighters who will benefit from this prop being in Punta Gorda. The $10 million project is expected to rake in a return.
For a long time, we've been very heavily weighted on the leisure side of tourism. And one thing we've been trying to do over the years is to try to diversify that.
We may go into some of the islands that need to come up and do training in the states. People outside of our state may need to come here when we're offering it.
Bringing in firefighters to train here will bring money to hotels, restaurants, and attractions in Southwest Florida.
This is a cool kind of niche. Hopefully, by bringing these people in, we may even generate some leads to bring in some meetings and conferences that are affiliated with the firefighters.
So when will you see this black beauty go up in smoke?
I think sometime in May.
We're just off I-75, so people driving past will be able to see flames and firefighters during training sessions. So just be aware, this is a learning tool and not an emergency. I'm in Charlotte County, Samantha Serban, NBC2.